and welcome to Jim and Tay Have Their Say,
where I get to be the lucky guy who gets to sit next to his daughter and hear what she has to say, and then she has to listen to me because that's the rule.
Yeah, we listen to each other.
Sorry, what was it?
Huh? Anyways, okay, so I had a question for you today. It's an interesting one. I've been trying to figure out how to formulate it, and let's see how I do. My question is in regards to problems, other people's problems. I was curious what your approach was when you have friends or people you know or in your life that you see having a lot of problems. Maybe they're coming to you for help on these things. Maybe they're not and you're just observing them. But I just was wondering what your take was on that situation. Because sometimes I feel like, I know for me, sometimes I'm like, I mean, I always like to help, but sometimes I am more inclined to help and sometimes I find that I'm less inclined to help for whatever reason. Like if the problem is like, oh, I don't know what to do about that at all, so I don't really feel like I can help or something like that, you know?
Yeah. Well, it sounds like your question is less about problems and more about help and the willingness to help. So this is interesting because in your life, you'll notice you're going to go through all different kind of attitudes about this. And I have noticed that there are many challenges to helping people. Now, when someone comes to me and says, hey, I need your help, that's the easiest thing in the world.
Definitely.
Because I have all this experience, all this knowledge that I've accrued over a lifetime. I mean, I'm no super genius, but there's always something that can be done, particularly if it's like, hey, I need to help with this artistic project or whatever. When it gets into interpersonal things, that's a little more challenging, but still, I always have something to say. But that's the very few times, the very small percentage of people who are worthy of help, who actually come to me and say, or write to me or whatever and say, what do you think? Or, you know, can you help me?
Like it's a small amount of people who actually do
that. Very small. Yeah. Like I feel like I'm a little bit wasted because people don't come to me and I wish they would. Mm. But perhaps something in my life or something has made them think, he's not the guy I want to talk to. So I understand that. Maybe that's just my own extrapolation of it. But I really enjoy, like you, I love to help people. I love to do things that are positive. So if someone says, hey, will you help me do this? I go, yeah, I'm on it. Tamara, all day long, she asks me to do things and I help her and she helps me, and that's a great relationship. When someone you observe obviously needs help, then you have to be a bit more crafty because you have to somehow persuade them to be willing to accept help.
Yeah,
and that is sometimes very, very challenging because people, I think, get embarrassed or they don't really believe that there's any help available.
Yeah.
Or that someone can actually help them.
It's failed in the past.
Yeah. Exactly. They've been betrayed in the past. So it's something that in life I think we all have to figure out and work around and see and always try and offer. And my mother's hilarious because my mother often doesn't pay attention to any of this. Marion will go up and say, now, to a perfect stranger, she will say, now we can just fix those teeth right up.
Yeah.
With the understanding that my mother's not a dentist. Or you know what? You could have an operation and have that leg and you wouldn't limp like that anymore. We could just do that in a month. Which is an offer of help although she will actually put her money behind it too. I've known her to do that, to actually help people with physical infirmities and things like, and you're like, but she doesn't have any back off. So maybe one thing I'm learning is that it is a good thing to be more outgoing and to say, hey, can I help you with that? Do you need help with anything? And when the person says, no, I'm good. I'm totally good. You go, wait a minute. I'm really willing to help you here. And then press it a little harder.
Yeah.
You know, that's the way I feel about it today. You know, if I see someone or know somebody that is like having difficulty, I might just try to corner them a little bit and say, you know, not for nothing, particularly if I know how to do something about it.
Yeah.
Let's just sit down, you and me, let's try and work this out.
Yeah.
And, you know, you're going to have disappointments. I've had many, many times when people went, yeah, no, I'm good. And they meant it. And you're like, okay. And then you see the result of that. And you're like, we could have avoided that, but you did not want my help.
It's funny because I think that is very wise. I recently actually just realized that I had a little block sometimes on people helping me. Mm. And I'd even gotten in like little tiffs with my roommate because she was trying to help me. I was trying to help her. And I was like, no, not accepting her help sometimes. Mm. I realized that I was doing that. And I think you're right. We have to be, as like a very beginning step, we have to be able and willing to help one another, which means if you want to help someone, which I'm sure you do, you probably want to help someone. You probably like it. Like, if you think about a time where you helped someone, that feels good, right? So give that to somebody else too, which that's really what made me just turn that idea around. Tear down that wall.
Tear down that wall, Mr. Gorbachev. Be willing to be helped and to give help.
All right, cool. All right,
good question. I like that too. Thank you for that. All right. What do you think about that? Please write it, you know, in the comments below with a ballpoint pen on your own lap. Don't do that. Type it in the comments below. We'd love to hear from you. Thanks for watching.
Bye.